So it's been nearly 2 years since I fitted these lightweight internal doors, and I've had a few comments saying it looks more difficult than they anticipated, but in truth, at the time I really wanted to challenge myself by chiseling out spaces for the hinges. But it can be done easier. So this week I'm gonna go back in time where we didn't have to do any social distancing, where me and my dad fitted doors, lightweight ones, with flush hinges. So keep on watching if you wanna see how it's done. So to start off with, I'm watching my dad fit the first door. And I'll leave a link to the flush hinges below, including the other video where I chiseled out traditional hinges and fit them myself. I won't go through all of the details about measuring your door width. You're best off going to watch that video. And one of the first things you need to do is determine which is the lock side and which is the hinge side. Usually there's print on the top of these doors or the bottom to tell you which way is which. Then I'd push the door into the hole, at least try to fit it in anyway. So at this point my dad had told me I need the thickness of the clearance off and the thickness of the hinges off. And something you can do is fit pennies all around the door to help guide you. And my dad very rarely needs to get a tape measure out because he has this trick with a steady hand to draw a straight line of the same thickness of what he wants to cut off. So then we plane that off with an electric plane, although forgot to hit record, so I'm gonna have to skip forward to another door to show you how we did it. But I cannot stress this enough. This is a really dangerous tool. Even my dad panics every time I use it and always says to have your hands on the top, never the side, and always wait for it to stop before you start moving your arms about or putting it on the floor. So once that's done, we put it back in the doorway to see if it's a good fit and see if it's even throughout. So we've shaved off a little bit, it's gone in, but we needed to fine tune it and take a little bit more off. And now my dad's showing me to push the whole thing to one side, then you can see on the opposite where you need a little bit more off. So the idea is we're making sure the sides are all equal. And after he'd taken a little bit more off, I'm pushing the top section over as well to see what gap is left. And now shaving that top piece off. And once you've fine-tuned any high spots, my dad recommends to go over it one more time from top to bottom. You can actually buy jigs that hold the door still, but I've got my dad holding it instead. Make sure the hands are away from the electric plane though. So now we know this door fits like a glove with clearance, so it opens okay. It's time to mark where the flush hinges go. And from what I've gathered over time, it's personal preference where you want to position your hinges.
9 inch from the bottom, 7 inch from the top.
Also, any heavier than these doors, it's probably best to use 3 instead of 2. But bear in mind, these doors are only about 13 kilograms. Something else that I learned is flush hinges come in different sizes. Now I'll leave a link to these below, but my dad said he prefers 4 inch flush hinges because they're a bit bigger, usually 75 mil. Apparently most people use 3 inch ones. And you'll also need to determine which way your door is gonna open. So it determines which way you're gonna have your hinge. And these hinges have lugs on them, which are protruding bits that when you position the flush hinges on the door, it stops it from going any further. So once you've got those lined up with the pencil marks, it is normally recommended to pre-drill holes to avoid splitting, but I just screwed them in and had no issues. So now those are on, I'm opening the hinges. I position the door in an open position. Does really help if you've got two people, one person holding the door, but I'm also using a chisel and a hammer method so I could press it down and pushing the hinge towards the frame until it stops. And normally this is where I'd put a penny at the top and screw it to the frame. But if you're a carpenter and you've fitted hundreds of doors, it's probably likely, like here, that you can do it by eye. And rather than getting ahead of yourself, my dad recommended to quickly add one in the bottom one so we could do a really quick check to see if everything was okay. I did find it much easier to do it this way because once you've put a hole in and you need to move it ever so slightly, you've got a bigger hole where the screw may not grip. So while everyone else is doing different jobs, I thought let's do some more. However, what I didn't experience this time is sometimes you need to trim off a bit more from the bottom. And again, it's worth watching that previous video because there's a hack that I used because you can only trim off a certain amount before a door becomes hollow. and I definitely prefer to use a handsaw rather than a circular saw. I just feel more in control with it. So now it's time to add the handles. And I was kindly gifted these from handleking.co.uk, and I was given a choice of which ones to install. And I was intrigued by these flashy ones that have a sensor where you get close up to it and it lights up. And I thought, this sounds cool for if you need to go to the toilet in the middle of the night. So again, I'll leave a link below if you are looking for something like this. So remember the lock side that was marked, that's where we're going to put the handles. And because we don't have any latches, my dad decided where they were going to go, roughly in line with the groove panels on the front of the door. So after a pencil line was put at the edge of the door, I needed to work out the center point of it so I could drill with a hole saw to put my latch in. And this is a size 25, although I found out I probably need some new ones. I don't know how to sharpen them anyway, because they just took ages to cut through the door. So once we'd drilled through it, we put the latch in, and then with a really sharp pencil, or you could use a sharp knife or Stanley knife, I drew around the latch to create a groove, and that way I knew where to chisel out. But before I did that, I held the latch against the edge of the door, penciled inside the hole where the door handle bar thing goes. If you're new, it always gets technical here. And then I used the hole saw again for that pencil mark. But this time, once I'd gone through one side, I'd then go onto the opposite side to finish the job. You'll know what I mean if you see that video. And now chiseling for the latch. Although I must stress my chiseling skills are not great, but it's just one of those things you need to practice, practice, practice. And you know, things don't have to be perfect. They just have to be good enough to how you want them to be. But if you take your time, like I did on my previous doors, then I'm sure you'll be fine. And then I'd put the latch in and just tap it with a hammer. That way the screw holes would sink into the wood. I also noticed I needed to chisel a little bit more off the bottom. And then finally, fit the latch in, screw it, and pop the handlebar bar and the handles on. Then I could make sure the handles were level and screw them to the door. Unfortunately, due to the pandemic, these handles aren't in front of me, so I can't show you them any closer right now. But the ends of the handles have a screw end that you remove, and you can pop AA batteries in there. And for the last job we needed to do was cut out a hole in the door frame for the latch. And my dad's trick was to go over it with a pencil, open and close it a few times so it'd leave a mark, then draw a center line, and instead of chiseling it out, my dad recommended to use a hole saw that was slightly bigger than the protruding latch on the door, and then we could screw to the door frame. But we also found we needed to move the latch plate slightly because it wasn't closing properly. And if you really wanted to, you could chisel a bit out for it. And once it was moved, I screwed it back, and that was it.
Walk up to it.
Yeah, I like that. So hopefully that's going to be useful to anyone who doesn't want to do it the long way round, and particularly right now where we can't really get a tradesman in as such just to put a door up. But yeah, I think everybody should learn how to do it anyway. Right, hopefully you're staying safe, and I'll see you in my next one. Thanks for watching. Bye.